In this video, we'll be building a text-to-speech converter. So it has to have two fields. Like in the first field, you will enter the text and whatever text you have written, so it should get converted to speech whenever you click on this convert speech button. So let's see the demo. Now, this is the basic layout design. Now here, if I enter something like Android Studio and if I click on this speak button,
Android Studio,
so this text has been converted into speech. So yeah, so this is what we'll be building. Okay, so now let's start by creating a new project. Clicking on this empty activity, and I will give the name as text to speech. Once the build gets completed, let's start with the design first. So go to the activity main and here. So I'll remove the text view. Okay, so I have removed the text view, and in here, first let us take a text and from here take this plain text and place it over there. Then you can add this constraint to this. And then take a button. And just add a constraint. Okay, so after this, let's give an ID to it. So here you can change this ID to so here you can give like text value. Or you can give it like entered text or entered value. And to this button, let's give an ID as speak button and change this text to speak. And here, in order to display something, just go to the code and in this edit text. So here, what you can give is, so it is having this Android text as name, so remove this field and give hint, and here you can give like enter your text. And so this was the basic design. So let's start with the backend part. Go to this main activity and here let's first create objects for these two fields, speak and this edit text. So here just give like edit text, and here you can create a variable and also for the button. Okay, so now we have these two variable, and and in this app we need to convert the text to speech, right? So for that, Android provides us with an inbuilt class called text-to-speech. So if you go to this text-to-speech class, so this is basically the class which it provides. And now in order to use this text-to-speech class in your main activity, so what you want to do is, so you need to create an object of this text-to-speech. So to do that, so whenever your app starts, so here you can create a new object for text to speech, and this object, so this is the object which you are creating, text to new object which you are creating. Okay, so this is the new object which is of the type text to speech. And here, now in order to create this, So either you have to use these two constructors. So in this, the first constructor basically takes two parameters and this one takes three parameters. So click on the first one, which takes two parameters, and if you go here, so here you can see, so this is a constructor, and so it takes this context and a on initializer method. So here context is nothing but, like, now you want to implement this text to speech in your main activity, right? So in the context, what you'll pass is, so in the main activity I want to initialize this, I want to use this, so I will pass the main activity has this context, main activity dot this, and then in here, so here you can see it's an on init listener function. So what I'll do is, I can just give like new text to speech. So if you click on the text to speech, so you can get this text to speech dot on init listener. So yeah, so if you go to this on init listener, you can see this is an interface. So that's why it is having this method called onInit. So with its only declaration, so it doesn't have any logic for this onInit function. So its logic we have to implement it in a main activity. So that's why we have given like override this onInit method, which is over here. And here we will, in this part, we will initialize this text to speech. So for that, I'll take this text to speech object which I have created. So in that, there is first of all we need to set a language to which we want. So I'll give like set language, and inside this set language, it takes a parameter called locally, and I have to give like locally dot whichever language I want. So I will make it as English. Okay, so here you can see an error, like variable text to speech might not have an initialize. So for this, what you can do is, so here you have declared it, right? So just copy this and put it on the top, and here remove this. So now the error will go. So it's basically like you have to declare it initially only. And yeah, so now what happens is, like whenever you start the your app, so basically an object of this text to speech class is created, and that text to speech engine or that like that object has been basically set to this English language. So yeah, here you can see in this function that is onInit, so there is a parameter called status. So what status this is, so basically it will it's of the type integer, and it will return either true or false value. For example, like now you have created this object, right? So if this object has been success, or if you have successfully initialized this object, so then its status value will be true, means like your app can, or this your application can use the text to speech engine. Or if it is false, like your app is not capable of using that. So what we have to do is, so if this value of the status is equals to so success, so then only you can use this text to speech object and set it to whichever language you want. So if it fails to load that, what you can do is you can just print the error so that it has been failed to load, and here you can give the tag like failed. Okay, so now what we have done is, so we have successfully created an object of this text to speech type, so which will basically set itself to English. So whenever it's been loaded successfully, so next what we want to do is, next whenever we click on this button, so I have to get whatever value which is present in this text field, and that text field I have to convert it into speech. So to do that, so just in this only, like, okay, so here what you can do is, on this speak button you can add a listener. So take the speak button and do this set on click listener. So before that, so I have not given like find by id, so let's do that first. So take the speak button, take the speak button and just do find view by id. So you have given the id as speak button, and also for the entered value you can do like find view by id dot r dot id dot this entered value. Okay, so now here on the speak button add a on click listener. So in it, in this you pass view on click listener. So now on click of that, what should happen is first let us get whatever value which you have written in this text field. So just go here and in this on click you have this object, right? Entered value. So from the entered value get text, you are getting it and you are converting it to a string. So after converting, let's assign it to a new variable, string variable called as text. Okay, so now you have got whatever you have written in the text field in this variable. So next, okay, so now after getting this text value, what you can do is you can make use of the text to speech object which you have created dot this method called speak. So in this, what you can do is, so here if you go, so in this it will take a text which is a character sequence, and then it has a queue mode and other parameters. So let's first pass in the text value, so this text value here, and then it takes a queue mode. So in order to get the queue mode, what you can do is you can take the text to speech class which you have, and in that there is something called as queue flush, and then for other parameters you can just pass like null. Okay, so here queue dot so this queue flush will basically ensure that like the previous things which you have entered will be not used, like only the current text which you have written, so that will be taken and it will be converted into speech. So that's why we are passing q.flush, and for other arguments you can pass in as null. So yeah, so let's see this once. So like, so whenever you, okay, so whenever your app gets created or whenever your app gets started, so this text to speech object is created with this English as its value, English as its language, and then when you click on the speak button, so yeah, so whatever you have entered in the edit text field, so that is taken into this text variable, and that text variable is passed in the text to speech method. So let's run this app and see. So this is what the design looks like, and if I enter some values like Android Studio, and if I click on speak,
Android Studio,
so the text which I have written over here is converted into the speech form. So yeah, so this was the main part. That's the main part of this app. And here in the text to speech, you can see a lot of different methods. Like also you can, in this there's a method like you can convert the speed of the speech sound, like how fast it's been speaking. So you can do that. You can use this method called set speech rate in order to control the speed of it. And here you can use the set pitch method to control the pitch, like how much depth should be there in the voice. So yeah, so this is the text-to-speech class which has been provided, and using that we have implemented this text-to-speech application.